Hi there, my name is Kenzie. I'm offering you a restorative yoga practice today here in the Everyday Counts program space. So a restorative practice is completely supported and supportive, nourishing the nervous system so we can experience deep levels of comfort and ease. It is helpful to have a few props. So I have two thick bed pillows. Those could be bolsters or big couch cushions. And I have two smaller folded blankets. These could be any size blanket really that you can work with. You could add extra pillows or blankets for comfort. You'll notice I'm wearing a hat, I'm wearing socks and a sweater because we don't create a lot of heat in the body for this practice. So let's begin by making ourselves comfortable, which is the most important kind of piece of this practice. It might be nice to rest your head on a pillow. It might be nice to place a blanket or a pillow under your knees and another one over your body. So another option would be to lay in a bed or to get on your couch, even to lay another blanket down here on the yoga mat if the floor is cold. And I've got just a little extra support of the blanket and the pillow under my knees. Let me see if this pillow is the right height for me. Yeah. And then maybe just a little bit of warmth here. So, wiggle around, get nice and comfortable. And perhaps close your eyes. And once you close your eyes, you might find that you're not as comfortable as you think, and that you are free to continue to wiggle about, to experiment, to move props, to adjust until you feel relatively comfortable. As you close your eyes, your senses are drawn inward. But sometimes closing the eyes just lets us focus on the other senses. And so we might start by focusing on the sense of hearing. And simply let your sense of hearing receive sound, as if this sense could reach out in all directions. Maybe starting with the sounds in the room that you're in. You don't need to label the sound or even know what it is. Just move your awareness from sound to sound. Now begin to listen for sounds beyond this room. So it might be in the larger house or building, or it might be outside sounds. But let's reach that sense of hearing out and receive the furthest away sounds we can hear. Now we are going to bring our sense of hearing as close as possible and begin to listen for our own breath as it moves in and out. switch and start to feel our own breath. So you might feel that there's cool air moving in past your nostrils or past your lips, and warmer air moving out. Notice the cool air moving in. The warmer air moving out. Let's simply slow that down. Cool air moves slowly in. Warm air moves slowly out. As we slow down our breath, our thoughts begin to slow down. As our thoughts slow down, we begin to inhabit the present moment more fully. And the present moment is where our body always resides. Your body is always present. So let's feel the presence of our own body. Let's feel the presence of our own breath. And let's offer ourselves some sweetness here in the present moment. If it suits you, perhaps rest a hand to the belly and a hand to the chest. And offer yourself a kind word, a prayer, an affirmation just for you. And feeling that sweetness land in the presence of your own body, your own mind, your own breath. And let's perhaps invite some movement, maybe a little finger wiggle, a toe wiggle, perhaps a gentle movement through the wrists or the ankles. You might yawn, you might stretch, or you might wish to remain right where you are for a little while longer. And if so, please
feel free to do so for as long as you are comfortable. If you are ready to invite a little more movement, perhaps slowly bend your knees and roll over perhaps to the right side for a moment. And pressing that top hand into the floor, we can slowly guide our way upright. Yeah. So we are going to move on to the next pose in this practice. And I'd like to invite a little bit of movement on our way. So moving those props out of the way, let's come on to all fours. In fact, you might want to place a blanket under the knees preemptively, just because it's more comfortable. And if on hands and knees, having those hands flat is uncomfortable as well, you could stack your pillows and place your forearms here. Yeah. So this movement is always optional and it can be the tiniest bit of movement. Yeah. So I found kind of a neutral spine here and I could try rocking a little bit forward and back. I could perhaps rock the hips from side to side. Maybe I could put that together and do more of a circular movement. That side to side, that forward and back, linked together. Perhaps closing your eyes, perhaps not. Perhaps letting that movement grow a little bit bigger, and perhaps not. And if we're circling in one direction, perhaps we change the direction. Again, moving nice and slow. In restorative, we're looking for movements and poses that bring us into a place of openness before stretch. So I know it's tempting to lean into those hips and kind of feel into the stretch, but I'm mellowing that so we can nourish the nervous system in these comfortable open places. Yeah. So let's slowly come back to center. Back to stillness, and we'll do one more bit of movement here. If you need to shake out the hands or adjust the arms, you can. We'll move through something called cat-cow, which is extension and flexion of the spine. Again, we're looking for that place of openness before stretch. So I'm tucking that tailbone down and beginning to slowly round the spine. And then turning that tailbone up as I begin to gently arch. Again, maybe closing your eyes, connecting to those hands, to those knees as we feel stable and supported by the floor. Leading with the tailbone, or perhaps even leading with the middle spine or with the crown of the head. We're moving everything together. We'll do this a couple more times in either direction. Back to neutral and simply find a way to comfortably watch me set up this next pose and move into it as soon as you know kind of what's going on, or see all of the options and then you can always press pause if you need more time to find your way into a pose. So what you'll notice is I have these two stacked pillows and I'm going to bring them kind of lengthwise on the mat, and then I may or may not have this or even a second blanket folded, so I've got a little space here. So this one involves explaining two variations of the pose depending on how your knees are feeling. So the first pose is a supported child pose. So again, I might even have that blanket under my knees or under my lower legs. I'm going to widen my knees so they're on either side of the pillows. And then I'm going to lower my belly and chest onto the pillows, perhaps turning my head to one side. Yeah. And at the halfway point, I'll remind you, you can turn your head to the other side. If this pose feels too deep in the knees, and it's okay to have those hips elevated in this pose, and even push those pillows further away to make space for belly. Yeah. Another option is to keep those legs nice and long, so you could kind of get on top of these pillows, kind of like on hands and knees, and then slowly lower yourself down onto them. In this case, our head is going to be over the end of the pillows, and we want to make a space for the face here so it's easy to breathe, and then perhaps roll up the blanket so it's just under your forehead. So lots of space to breathe. Yeah, some people like to roll a blanket under the tops of their feet, especially if the legs lying long like that is uncomfortable stretch, so you could have a blanket under the tops of the feet there. And if breast tissue is quite uncomfortable or tender here, you could bring those pillows a little closer to you, or even width-wise. So as you come over here, you could have the chest, less pressure on the chest. You could be right off the end here if you wanted. So just know that that's a possibility. So hopefully one of these options is comfortable for you. Find your way there. Remember, the child pose variation is lovely too. Notice where the forearms want to be. Maybe they want to rest at the sides, maybe down long, maybe overhead. As you close your eyes, you might be able to tune in more to your comfort level. So if need be, change position, adjust breast tissue, whatever you need. And then begin to settle. We so rarely lie prone in this way, and it can be such a lovely opportunity to soften the front of your body and let it kind of melt onto the soft support beneath you. This can be a really novel experience to be held by gravity and supported by the floor in this way. So let's pick up where we left off with the breath in our last pose. Remember, we had that cool, slow in-breath through the nostrils, if possible, or through the lips, if need be. And then that warmer, slower out-breath. Cool, soft in-breath. Warmer, slower out-breath. And of course, there's some compression to the abdomen in this pose. So you're going to start inviting the low back and the side waist. Kind of expand with that in-breath. And to soften and settle with the out-breath. That soft, deep in-breath. Landing at the waist and at the low back. And that warmer, slower out-breath invites you to melt into the soft support beneath you.
as we slow down our breath, our thoughts begin to slow down. As our thoughts slow down, we begin to inhabit the present moment more fully. And the present moment is where the body always resides. Your body is always present. And so if you turned your head to one side, slowly turn your head to the other side. You will feel that cool, deep in-breath expanding into the back and waist. That warmer, slower out-breath helping us melt into the soft support beneath us, held by gravity, fully supported earthward. Cool, deep breath in. Warmer, slower breath out. Feel the cool breath in. Feel the warmer breath out. If you feel a deep need to stay right where you are, please feel free for as long as you are comfortable. If you feel ready to move, perhaps it's your fingers or toes, or perhaps there's a yawn, maybe the wrists or the ankles are moving a bit more. Moving nice and slow here, perhaps walk your hands or glide your hands under your shoulders. We're going to push the mat away to come back upright.
Again, we'll move those props out of the way. As we bring our legs out in front of us, we can lean into the hands. Yeah. Take the feet wide. You can be on forearms here if you prefer. And rock those knees from side to side. I know things are starting to feel pretty slow at this point in the practice. And hopefully that feels kind of delicious. Yeah. I'm going to turn sideways so it's a little easier for you to see this next movement. And these movements are all completely optional. It's a little bit of a way to prepare the body for the next pose, but not of great necessity, especially if there is any discomfort. And this practice is all about comfort. So let's meet with our knees at center. And as our knees fall to the right, we're pressing into that right hand and sweeping the left arm off the mat and slowly around. And then we'll reach those fingertips away from us as our arm floats back around. The knees might come to center as the hand comes back down. Let's try it on the other side. So the knees are going to fall to the left, leaning into the left hand. Let's sweep the right arm off the mat and reach it behind us. And then slowly back. Come to center as the hand comes back. We'll do that a couple more times on either side. Leaning into that right hand, sweeping the left arm around, and the head and neck can turn here with the spine. And slowly back. You're welcome to do this with your eyes closed if it feels better. Once more in either direction. And we'll meet back at center. Yeah. So our next pose will have similar elements to that supported child pose in the sense that we will have the chest on the pillows. But you'll see, and they're also stacked in that similar way. So lengthwise stacked on top of each other, but there's a few differences. So as you can see right now, my legs are out to the sides and my hip is right up against the end of those pillows. So I'm going to lean into the pillows and then bring my legs to the other side of the mat. And I'm just comfortably bending them here. So they don't have to be perfectly stacked. Kind of just where they want to be comfortably. And that could be different for everyone. I know for me, I like to have a pillow between the knees or between the legs. And that's different for everyone, so that's something you can play with. I'm using a blanket instead of a pillow. And then notice here, I'm going to bring my hands to either side of the pillow. So already you'll see a little bit of a twist. So if that's too much, we don't have to twist so far. So we can adjust those legs. So I've got either hand to these pillows, and then I'm going to lower my belly and chest onto the pillows, turning to face the same direction as my knees. Now, again, everyone's different, and these are similar variations to the last one. If there's too much compression to the belly, you could push those pillows further away, so there's just more space for the belly to hang freely. There is going to be a little chest compression here, so you will probably have to adjust breast tissue, but you can often place, you know, a little bit of blanket either under the head to put a little less pressure on the chest, or even up under one elbow or forearm or the other one. And I know for me, I like to actually rest this forearm on the blanket just so my arms sort of aren't floating in space, or even just to support that top shoulder or give space for the chest. So again, everyone's going to be different here, and hopefully I've given you some options for comfort, but that you might have to experiment a little bit on your own. Okay, so again, we can check our comfort level perhaps by closing our eyes. And then if there's still some discomfort, can we make any adjustments? Sometimes the bottom hip's a bit bony, so we could place extra support under the bottom hip. Maybe we're feeling a bit cold, an extra blanket or sweater. And so continue to assess your comfort. And then begin to tune into your breath. That cool, deep in-breath. And if there's compression to the belly here, again, there's this invitation to invite that in-breath into the waist and into the back. That warmer, softer out-breath, again, opportunity to soften and sink into these lovely, soft pillows. I'd like to journey a little bit more with the senses. We've done some listening, and that sense is always active. And now I'd like to notice your eyes. And with your eyes closed, I invite you to notice your eyes seeing. And so with eyes closed, we're still seeing light through the eyelids. And can you feel your eyes seeing? Can you see your eyes seeing through those closed eyelids? And now we're going to move down to our nose, but instead of feeling the temperature of the breath there, let's notice if we can feel our nose smelling. And unless you're in a kitchen at dinner time, it's hard to notice smells. So as you take your next few breaths, even just notice the absence of smell if there's nothing much to smell. Feel your nose smelling. Now I invite you to drop your awareness into your mouth and feel your tongue tasting. You might need to swallow, you might need to move your tongue a bit, and depending, there might not be a lot of taste in your mouth. And yet still, you can feel for that. feel for taste. Feel your tongue tasting. Now for the next 7 or 8 breaths, let's return to feeling the body breathing. That is a sense all on its own. To feel the cool, deep in-breath. And the warmer, slower out-breath. Soft and deep, and soft and slow for a few moments more, a few breaths more. If you feel a deep need to stay right where you are, please feel free. If you do feel ready to move, again, maybe it's the fingers or toes. Oh, maybe there's a little yawn. I'm beginning to walk your hands under your shoulders. We'll gently push the mat away. So you can move right into this pose on the other side, or if you do need to invite a little bit of movement, we can come back to those first movements we did. So we rocked those knees side to side with the feet wide, leaning into those hands. And then maybe we added that simple twist, lean into one hand, sweep the other arm around. Perhaps once more, either side, and perhaps not. So it might be as simple as bringing your opposite hip to those pillows. Or if you do want to keep an eye on me, like I want to keep an eye on you, you can bring those pillows to the opposite hip. And gathering whatever you think you might need, knowing that you might need different things on this side. So I'm going to lean into my pillows and bring my legs to the other end of my mat. I know I like to tuck a blanket in here. Bringing hands to either side of these pillows. So I lower myself down with control, turning to face the same direction as my knees. And I've got this blanket in here to support this forearm. And that also lets me kind of lean a bit more into one side and keep that top rest a little less pressure on it. Yeah. Once again, as we close our eyes and become still, we might notice some discomfort that remains, and we can continue to experiment to keep increasing our comfort, because we know our comfort matters most of all in this practice. And eventually settling in. And starting to tune into the breath. That cool, deep in breath. Expanding into the back, expanding into the waist. Even as we soften through the belly to receive. A nice, slow, warm exhale. Softening the body onto the support beneath us, surrendering to gravity and letting ourselves be held and supported. I thought we could return again to those other senses and come back to sensing our eyes. Seeing behind our closed eyelids. Open curiosity to those closed eyes seeing. And still the breath rolls in cool and deep, rolls out warm and slow. And let's move down to our nose. Let's notice if we can feel our nose smelling. Let's move into our mouth. Can we feel our tongue tasting? You might need to swallow or kind of move your tongue around your mouth for a moment. Drop into that sense of taste.
as you rest here for 5 or 6 more breaths, let's come back to feeling the body breathing. That cool, deep in breath, expanding the body. A warmer, slower out breath, softening the body, releasing the breath. If you feel a deep need to stay right where you are, please feel free for as long as you are comfortable. If you are ready to invite some movement, let's wiggle the fingers or toes. Maybe there's a yawn. Oh, there's always a yawn for me. We can slowly walk our hands under our shoulders and just as slowly push the floor away. So it is time for our final relaxation. It can be just like the first one. I'm going to adjust mine a tiny bit by placing my blanket under my head and stacking both pillows under my knees. That gives more of a legs up the wall feel. And I've cooled down quite a bit, so I'm going to be prepared to put more of the blanket over my body. So moving nice and slow here. If you want to grab more props, you can always press pause. If you want to move around a little bit, you could pause me for that as well. Bathroom break. That's the joy of a recorded class in your own home. So get nice and cozy. Settle yourself in. And once again, closing your eyes and noticing if you're comfortable. If you're not, continue to make tiny adjustments so that you feel supported and warm and comfortable and at ease. Your comfort matters most of all. And tuning into that breath, feeling your body breathing. It might be as simple as sensing the rise and fall of your abdomen. For our final relaxation, I'd like to focus on our biggest sense organ, which is the skin, and that awareness of the sense of touch. And so we'll begin with our feet, and your feet might be floating like mine, or they might be touching the floor. You might be wearing socks, you might not. But let's tune into the feet and what is touching them. And so if the feet are against the floor, notice wherever the floor touches the feet, that gentle pressure. And if
you're wearing socks, notice that even gentler pressure against the feet. Are these short socks or tall socks? If your feet are bare, feel the air against the skin of your feet. And so we're sensing the feet as the feet sense air or clothing or the pressure from the floor. And now let's move our awareness to our legs. They might be resting over those pillows. They might be resting on the mat. And you sense that gentle pressure from the pillows or from the floor. Pressing into the backs of the legs. Feel that gentle pressure. And now you might be wearing shorts or pants or leggings. Can you feel that gentle pressure against the skin of the legs? We are simply feeling our legs, feeling. Now let's move up to the torso. You could feel where your buttocks and parts of your back gently press against the floor or the soft support beneath you. Feel that gentle pressure, that gift of gravity. Now begin to notice clothing or air against the skin of your torso. You might notice a waistband or a bra strap. So varying degrees of pressure from clothing, warmth or coolness. Now let's bring awareness to our arms and hands. First, noticing where they touch the floor, touch down on the soft support beneath you. Feel that gentle pressure wherever the arms and hands touch down. And now begin to notice clothing and air against the skin of your arms and hands. floating that awareness to your neck and head. Feel the gentle pressure at the back of the head where it touches down on that soft support. Perhaps noticing the warmth of scalp, the air against the skin of your face and neck. As we rest here for just a few more moments, let's spread that awareness out. You can feel the gentle pressure of the floor against the back of your head, perhaps against the backs of the arms and hands, against your back and buttocks, the backs of the legs and feet, feeling the soft support beneath. Let's notice the rise and fall of our abdomen with each in-breath and out-breath. Soft support beneath. Gentle rhythm of the breath. Rolling in and rolling out. If you feel a deep need to remain right where you are, please do so for as long as you are comfortable. If you'd like to close the practice with me, perhaps bring a hand to the belly and a hand to the chest. And once more, offer yourself some sweetness, a kind word, a prayer, an affirmation. Just for you. This is where I will leave you. When you are ready to move, move slowly. Take your time.
Thank you so much for joining me today. If you have any questions or concerns, always feel free to reach out to us at the Everyday Counts program. I hope to see you again soon. Bye for now.